you. It's up. On my
phone. Reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We ask you, brothers and sisters, with regard to the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and our not to be shaken out of your minds suddenly, or to be alarmed either by a spirit or by an oral statement, or by a letter allegedly from us to the effect that the day of the Lord is at hand. Let no one deceive you in any way. To this end, he has also called you through our gospel to possess the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, brothers and sisters, stand firm and hold fast to the traditions that you were taught, either by an oral statement or by a letter of ours. May our Lord Jesus Christ himself and God our Father, who has loved us and given us everlasting encouragement and good hope through his grace, encourage your hearts and strengthen them in every good deed and word. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord comes to judge the earth.
The Lord comes to judge the earth.
Say among the nations, the Lord is King. He has made the world firm, not to be moved. He governs the peoples with equity.
The Lord comes to judge the earth.
Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice. Let the sea and what fills it resound. Let the plains be joyful and all that is in them. Then shall all the trees of the forest exult.
The Lord comes to judge the earth.
Before the Lord, for he comes to rule the earth. He shall rule the world with justice and the peoples with his constancy.
The Lord comes to judge the earth.
Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You cleanse the outside of cup and dish, but inside they are full of plunder and self-indulgence. Blind Pharisee, cleanse first the inside of the cup, so that the outside also may be clean. The Gospel of the Lord.
Thank you.
husband and wife. We're preparing for Thanksgiving, preparing to welcome their extended family to their homes. And as they were preparing, the wife says to the husband, "Will you take care of the leaves?" And he said, "Oh, by all means, no problem. I can do that." And they went off to continue their morning preparation. Well, a couple times throughout the morning, she walked through the dining room and the table didn't seem to be any different than it was when she asked the question. So a few moments later, both husband and wife meet within the dining room. And she said, "Honey, I ask you to take care of the leaves." He said, "Yes, dear, I will get to it. But before I go outside and clean up the leaves, I thought I should help you prepare the table for Thanksgiving dinner." Miscommunication. The leaves outside were the leaves of the table. No miscommunication between Jesus and his listeners today. Very direct and very to the point. And so we gather this day to enhance our communication between ourselves and our God, between ourselves and one another, and I pray also for our country, that indeed we can look not only to the simple little things of the law, but the weightier moments of law, of mercy, of peace, and of justice. But a mercy, a peace, and a justice that comes from the Lord himself and comes through his passion, death, and resurrection, that is borne out in self-giving and in self-sacrifice. Many would say our country has become just a wee bit selfish and a wee bit self-centered. But as we gather around the sacred table, around the altar of the Lord, there is indeed none of that. We are centered in our common baptism. We are centered in our prayer. And we are centered as the body and the blood of Jesus Christ within his table and within each and every one of us. We the rocks that make up the church. We the ones upon whom this day Christ continues to build his church. As we ask through divine mercy that the Lord have mercy on us and on the whole world, as we ask through the gift of our Blessed Lady that our souls may proclaim the greatness of the Lord, that we ask through St. Michael that he may defend us in this battle close at hand. We pray not only for an end to the pandemic, but we pray for all those on the front line and all essential workers. We pray for those within our country who prepare to go back to school and their teachers and administrators. And we pray for our nation, that our leaders may be attuned first and foremost to keeping us one nation under God, to a proclamation of the sanctity of human life, to a proclamation of the equality and the justice as each and every one of us created in the image and likeness of God. We may gather and say, but there is so much to pray for, so many things. May it be just one thing today, that God's will be done, and that we may be his servants, his handmaids. And this day, may it be a day of communication, be ourselves and our God, and first and foremost, for the healing of our nation, and to proclaim the true and abiding presence of Jesus Christ in the Blessed Sacrament. Have a great day, be safe, be well. With faith. trust we bring our needs and the needs of our brothers and sisters to the Lord. For all members of the church, may Christ keep us faithful to the gospel. We pray to the Lord. For all people of the world, may the Lord's love and mercy be upon them and bring them to salvation. We pray to the Lord. For those who live each day with fears and anxieties, may the Holy Spirit be their comfort and strength. We pray to the Lord. For this community of faith, may God continue to fill us with his gifts of, with his gifts and graces. We pray to the Lord. For the safety and security of all of our military personnel serving throughout the world, for all those essential workers, and for all the sick, and especially for the health of Pat Harding, who we remember in this liturgy, we pray to the Lord. For the faithful departed, may the Lord welcome them into eternal peace. We pray to the Lord. And together we pray. Loving and generous God, it is you who call us by name and ask us to follow you. Help us to grow in the love and service of our church as we experience it today. Give us the energy and courage of your Spirit to shape its future. Grant us faith-filled leaders who will embrace Christ's mission of love and justice. Bless the Church of Allentown Diocese by raising up dedicated and generous leaders from our families and friends who will serve your people as sisters, priests, brothers, deacons, and lay ministers. Inspire us to know you better and open our hearts to hear your call. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, the gifts we offer in this time of peril. May they become for us by your power a source of healing and peace through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Amen. Lift up your hearts. Give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just that we should give you thanks and praise, O God Almighty Father, for all you do in this world through our Lord Jesus Christ. For though the human race is divided by dissension and discord, yet we know that by testing us you change our hearts to prepare them for reconciliation. Even more, by your Spirit you move human hearts that enemies may speak to each other again, adversaries join hands, and people seek to meet together. By the working of your power, it comes about, O Lord, that hatred is overcome by love, revenge gives way to forgiveness, and discord is changed to mutual respect. Therefore, as we give you ceaseless thanks with choirs of heaven, we cry out to your majesty on earth, as without end, we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he. He himself is the word that brings salvation, the hand you extend to sinners, the way by which your peace is offered to us. When we ourselves had turned away from you on account of our sins, you brought us back to be reconciled, O Lord, so that converted at last to you, we might love one another through your Son, whom for our sake you handed over to death. And now, celebrating the reconciliation Christ has brought us, we entreat you, sanctify these gifts by the outpouring of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, whom command we fulfill when we celebrate these mysteries. For when about to give his life to set us free as he reclined at supper, he himself took bread in his hands, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, on that same evening, he took the chalice of blessing in his hands, confessing your mercy, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Celebrating, therefore, the memorial of the death and resurrection of your Son, who left us this pledge of his love, we offer you what you have bestowed on us, the sacrifice of perfect reconciliation. Holy Father, we humbly beseech you to accept us also together with your Son, and in this saving banquet, graciously to endow us with his very Spirit, who takes away everything that estranges us from one another. May he make your church a sign of unity and an instrument of your peace among all people. And may he keep us in communion with Francis, our Pope, and Alfred, our Bishop, all the bishops, and your entire people. Just as you have gathered us now at the table of your Son, so also bring us together with the glorious Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and all the saints, with our brothers and sisters and those of every race and tongue who have died in your friendship. Bring us to share with them the unending banquet of unity in a new heaven and a new earth, where the fullness of your peace will shine forth in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, O glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, in Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, from whose hand we have received the medicine of eternal life, grant that through this sacrament we may glory in the fullness of heavenly healing through Christ our Lord.
Amen. I thank you for your presence here this morning and beginning this day of intense prayer before the Blessed Sacrament. Immediately after the reception of Holy Communion, we will expose the Blessed Sacrament and begin our time of prayer. If you can remain with us for that exposition and for a period of silent prayer, please go back to exactly the same places where you were here at this present moment. If you need to go on to work and to appointments and to daily duties, I understand that fully just leave as you normally do leave. As you come back later today, after we get into the routine and the normal adoration, there are cans of hand sanitizer, and not only hand sanitizer, but the spray. I just ask you to spray the area where you are seated and then to use the hand sanitizer as you enter and you leave the church. The Lord be with you. The Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Saint Michael, the Archangel,
the defense of thy hour, be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God give you
begin this time of adoration throughout the rest of today. We will gather at 6:30 this evening for a holy hour through the very guidance and mercy of the divine mercy of the Lord.
Please join in the hymn of exposition, Jesus, my Lord, my God, my all, verses 1 and 3. Jesus, my Lord, my God.
Still my soul.